Greetings everyone. In this video, I will show you how you can use Stable Diffusion 2.1 with Stable Diffusion Web UI developed by Automatic 1111. I am working on a full course that will hopefully explain every details about how to use Web UI to fully utilize Stable Diffusion. So while I was trying to make version 2.1 work with the Web UI, I had some difficulties. So let me show you how you can make Stable Diffusion 2.1 work with the Web UI. This is the official page of the Stable Diffusion, the Stability AI, who releases the models. And this is their Hugging Face page where they release their models. You see there is a there are several models and Stable Diffusion 2.1 and there is Stable Diffusion 2.1 base. So you may ask, what is the difference of them? The base version is 512 by 512 pixels and the regular version is 768 and 768. So this is the latest and the better version. I am going to use that on the Web UI. So I am clicking files and versions and I am going to download the file which is MAA preunit. You see they are same file size. So you may wonder what is the difference. MAA is for further optimizing, further tuning the model. So usually it was larger size, but now it is same size. So it is better to use that. You see now I am downloading the file. Okay, so the file has been downloaded. Let's go to our downloads folder quickly. You see the file is here. I am going to cut it. Okay, and then where am I going to paste this is I'm going to my installation of Stable Diffusion Web UI, and from there I'm going to models, and from there you see there is a Stable Diffusion folder. I am going to paste it there. Are we done yet? No, we are not done yet. In the Stable Diffusion GitHub there is a file. It is called it is inside the configs folder and it is Stable Diffusion folder. You see there are YAML files. This is for configuration, and for 768 pixel we are going to use the one ends with the V. Okay, this is the file that we need. We are going to click RAW. Don't worry, I will put the links of these files into the description of the video, and in here we are going to click save as. We are going to save as this inside our installation. We go to our models folder and in there we are going to Stable Diffusion folder and we are going to save it in here. Okay, are we done yet? No, this is saved as txt, but its extension has to be txt. Okay, its extension has to be YAML. Okay, so if you are not able to see the extension like this, you need to go to Weave and then from here you see file name and extension is checked. If I uncheck it, it is displayed like this and it won't work. You need to check this from here and then you need to right click, rename, delete the .txt. Now click yes, it will become the correct file extension, but we are still not done yet. We need to make these files same name. So I'm going to click the right click and rename. I will copy the name. You can also use Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V or F2 to rename. So when I click F2, it will automatically select and I will do Ctrl-V and it will be pasted like this. Okay, so now we are ready. There is one final thing, which is modifying the command line of the bat file that we are running. So I am going to open it with the right click and open with there is no open with. So I'm going to open it with my text editor, which is Notepad++. You can also open it with Notepad. So to open it with Notepad, I am going to open a Notepad file like this. And I am going to drag and drop it so it is opened like this, you can see. And from here we are going to set two command line arguments which are like this. Let me zoom in. Okay, --- xformus and --- no -half. Xformus is for boosting performance. If your graphic card is not supporting, you don't need to put this, and this is necessary for the newest version. It increases its precision. So if you are wondering what are these command line arguments, the command line arguments of Automatic 11.11.1 is released in its wiki like this. I will also put this link into the description. And you see there are a lot of command line arguments, and you can see what they are doing. Okay, so then we are saving it with file and save, and we are completely ready right now. We are just clicking web UI user.bat, and it will start processing the necessary files. Okay, the messages displayed here is very important. You see I have no error messages here. It says that the config from this YAML is loaded, and the model file loaded from here, the weights and xforms is applied, and also it has loaded the let me see, hyper network that I have developed and other things. So I have no errors here. Now we open the web UI like this. It shows the URL in here. As you can see, you can copy and paste it that. Okay, from this left and top, you can change the models. So if I set the model like this, let's see what happens. Okay, after I have restart the application, I am now able to change the model on runtime. So you see now it is changing the model, loaded model on runtime. Okay, and okay, currently model is loaded, and our model is now 2.1 with 768 pixels. Okay, so I have made a test with version 1.5. I have generated 9 images of futuristic tank artwork with the other all generic keywords and with generic keywords of negative prompt. I will put all of these positive and negative prompts into the description and the comment section of the video, so don't worry. I have used 20 sampling steps and DPM++ STA Keras as the sampling method. The native resolution of 1.5 is 512 pixel by 512 pixel, so I didn't change it. I made the batch count 9 and the seed -1. There is one another thing, important thing that I want to mention is that I have unloaded all of the hyper networks and embeddings. So this is the raw test of the version 1.5, the official version. So each generation took about 15 seconds, as you can see on RTX 3060. Okay, and let's check out the images right now. So since they are native resolution 512 pixel, their quality decreases when we display them in a bigger screen like this. The images like this, I think they are pretty low quality since we didn't use any artist style. We have only used generic artworks, generic keywords. Okay, now we are seeing results of version 2.1 with the exactly same setup, exactly same parameters. Only I have changed it to native resolution, as can be seen here, 768. And I have changed the model on the runtime, as can be seen here. You see, it says that model loaded. Let's check out the images it has generated. Okay. So you see, since the resolution is bigger, it is looking better when we do increase in size when displaying. Okay. Yeah, definitely better than version 1.5, but this is because in our prompts we didn't use any of the style of the existing artists. Okay, we have only used the generic keywords. That is why it is like this. Also, the inference time is more than 2 times of the regular 1.5 version. Okay, so this time we are seeing analog diffusion results. This is another model that is popular. So you see I have changed it on the runtime again, and it takes same about time with the original model 1.5. The results are like this, as you can see. I can say that it is not very good by default for generating this kind of images. Okay, To be able to use analog diffusion, I have downloaded the file from Hugging Face and I have generated another YAML file, as you can see here. So where did I get this file? This is the original 1.0 file, which you can find on this GitHub page. Let me show you. It was one second. Here, yeah, it is on this page. It was also inside one of my folders, so I have copied pasted there, and it is the same. I will also put link of this with the same method as I have shown in the beginning. You just save it and name it. Okay, now this time we are seeing anything V3 model results. I think it is pretty cool when we consider it. It is older version 1.5 based model. Okay, let's check it out. So I can say that it is even better than version 2.1, as you can see. Okay, I have used the same setup and same settings, same prompt. So you can try different models. It is always the same principle. You download the model, you put it inside the model folder, and you generate its YAML file. I don't know how this is pronounced, so I am pronouncing it like that. You just copy and paste this and rename it like this one. So where you can get these models? You can get those models on Hugging Face. So this is the official repository. From here I am clicking Stable Diffusion tag, so it is going to search all models inside the Hugging Face with Stable Diffusion tag, and you see the Arcane Diffusion or the anything V3 is in the top 4 actually, as you can see here. So you can also sort by recent updated, or you can sort by most likes. It is up to you. You can try and test different models from here. Just download, copy paste, and change the model from where? From here. Click this and it will refresh the models inside your folder, and you are ready to go. I hope you have enjoyed our video. Please consider liking, sharing, commenting our video to support us. And if you are generous, more generous, you can also support us on Patreon. That would help us significantly to produce better quality videos. So far we have 0 patrons, but you may be the first one. Thank you very much. Hopefully see you in another video.